Welcome to the Solar Energy Channel, where you will get an honest inside look at all things solar. My name is Charles Fox.
And I'm Warren Miller. And in this video, we're going to talk about adding panels to an existing solar system. Before we jump into the content, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel so you'll get notified of future videos just like this.
So Warren, I hear that you are considering adding panels to an existing system you already have. So walk us through what brought you to that point.
You know, I installed my system a little over a year ago on my home, which was new construction. Wasn't quite sure how large to design my system, and I most certainly didn't take into account adding on an electric vehicle, which is something I might want to do in the future. So given the current environment and the tax credit this year, I'm wondering if now's the time to add panels to my system.
So if you find yourself in the same situation as Warren, here are some things that you're going to want to consider. And number one is the obvious one. Do you have enough of space to add on to your existing system? So you're going to have to add panels on. And so do you have the available space? Is there a southern exposure? Is it shade free? So that is number one. The second thing that you're going to want to think about is, do you know how much capacity you need? So do you have a good feel of how much your existing system is producing and the difference that your utility is making up in the course of a year? And so you want to make up that difference with adding more panels on. So do you have a good handle on the capacity that you're looking to accomplish by adding more panels?
You also want to make sure, Charles, that you're allowed to, or there aren't any restrictions preventing you from adding any solar or the amount of solar that you want to add. You might be restricted by your utility company preventing you from adding on solar or a certain amount of solar. You might be limited by space or setbacks or other restrictions. So there might be some restrictions that prevent you from adding on.
And then you will get the solar income tax credit if you add panels onto an existing system, if it's new equipment. So if you're adding more panels, more inverters, more racking, all that would be eligible for the income tax credit.
Thanks for watching. We hope you found this video valuable. We'd love to hear your feedback in the comment section below.